Hello and welcome for the first part of the tutorial on how to design a football cleat using the 3D Shape Designer license and its three apps, XDesign, XShape Design and XGenerative Design. So let's start with the XDesign app with a new component that we will name Football Cleats. First of all, because I am not used to design soccer shoe, I will add some pictures. Here a picture of the profile that I place on the YZ plan. I place it wherever I want and it will help me for my design. When it's done, I create several sketches that I place here again on the YZ plan. In my first sketch, I try to fit the top of the shoe with a spline. As you can see here, I place my dots all along the top. Until the edge. And when it's done, I can validate my sketch and I don't forget to rename it here, top. I follow the same process for the two other sketches that are the back and the bottom. And because my shoe is a 3D object, I add a second picture of the bottom of a bottom view with the view of the soil on the XY plane this time. And I placed this picture trying to fit with the first picture. When it's done, I can validate. And here again, I create another sketch on this XY plan all around the soil with one spline again. And because it's something I have already done at the start of the video, I accelerate it. You will see during my tutorials, some parts will be accelerated like this either because I have already done similar operations or because it would be too long for you and for me. And we are done with the XDesign app. We have created several sketches that will help us in the next steps, that is to say in the XShape design, so we can switch. So here we are in the XShape design environment. I place myself in the subdivision tab in order to create a subdivision surface that could be a pyramid, a cone, a torus, a glob, or a cylinder. I choose the cylinder and I place it normal to this plane. I can change its scale. Pulling this arrow, I make it longer. I add some subdivisions in order to have a more precise design. I do it here also, in this direction. But what I want is not a cylinder, I want a semi-cylinder. And pulling this arrow, I can get it. It opens my cylinder. And with an angle of 180 degrees, I get it. When I validate my surface, the robot appears. It looks like a coordinate surface with these arrows, and selecting this plane enables me to move my surface in this plane. If I turn, I can also do it in this plane, and I try to fit it with my sketches, and I think it's too long. So with this white circle, I can reduce it in this direction. Now I think it's okay, so I can start to reshape it. I select the dot I want to move and the robot always appears. I do it step by step. And as you can see here, I don't have enough subdivisions to fit my sketches, so I will have to add more. I select this edge and the function insert loops, and it will automatically create loops, the number of loops I set here. And now I have more subdivisions to fit my sketches. Maybe another loop would be nice here on this edge. Only one this time. And as you can see here, my faces are becoming dark, and this is not a good signal. It means that the design is maybe too abrupt at this place, so make sure that you don't have too dark surfaces. Like here, it disappeared, as you could see. Another loops here would be nice too. The top and the back are done. Now we will fit the bottom sketch following the very same process. As you can see, when I select my dots, creating the yellow squares, it also selects the dots that are behind, so you have a symmetrical moving of the dots. I make the last adjustments. And now we have a perfect shoe for a Playmobil. So it's a good start. However, this shoe is not supposed to be a Playmobil shoe, so first we save it and we will do the same job as the previous step, but from the bottom view. By default, the Any Entities selection mode is activated, but for this step I will use the Edge Loops selection mode, because as you can see, when you select an edge, it selects the whole loop associated. So from the bottom, I select loop by loop and I place it to fit the sketch named Soil. The robot also enables you, as you can see here, to rotate the selected entities. And I do my best to make it look good. And now you really see the usefulness of the sketches we have created in the XDesign app. I can come back to the Any Entity selection mode for the last dot. And we progress. It looks a little bit more like a real shoe for a human this time. Now let me add just a few adjustments on some dots. These ones, I want to lower them. And for me, this shoe is really the worst shoe I have seen. There isn't any hole to wear it, and that's a big problem. So I have to create it first by bending some edges using the function crease edges. And I select the edges I want to bend, and you will see after I validate it, that they will appear purple. Now, I use the function remove faces that is still in the subdivision tab, and I select all these faces. And the hole appears. Now I think it would be really easier to wear this shoe. And of course we don't forget to save our work. If you have a squared ankle, this is a perfect shoe for you, you should buy it. However, for normal people, I think this part needs a few adjustments. So I can display the picture of the profile. And then make my adjustments, selecting the dots. I decide to select them by pair in order to have something symmetrical. The profile seems good, but from the top view you can see that the hole is kind of squared. So let's make it more round. Then a small tip for you, if you double click here, you see that the whole loop is selected. So it's faster than selecting the edge loops selection mode, as I showed you earlier in this video. Now I had my picture. This is still not good, so I make my last adjustments. Perfect. Now I see three parts that could be improved. The back, this side, and the other side. Both of the sides are too straight for me, and the back can be improved. So let's start with the back. We have already done 80% of the job for the upper part of the shoe. It's just adjustments in order to make it more realistic. Now I want to curve this side. It would be nice to have a function like to subdivide the faces, and it exists, subdivide faces, so selecting this function and the faces, it creates more subdivisions on them. Appearing here in yellow before I validate. Now I select the faces I want to curve. And pulling in this direction creates a more curvy surface for the heel. I think this dot isn't aligned with the others, so another tip for you. I want to displace this dot on this edge. To do that, I drag it, selecting the big white circle at the center of the robot. And now you can see it's aligned with the other dots. For the other side, I follow the very same process, first creating new subdivisions on the faces. And pulling some edges and faces for the heel again. After a quick overview, I think I can get out of the Subdivision Surface Edition environment by clicking here. And now I want to show you the view modes in the View tab. Here, you can switch to several view modes, such as this one or this one, and this one is a more realistic display of your design. And it's a nice way to see the imperfection on your design, such as this part. I see another one here. There is like a crack in my shoe. So now I know what to modify, and with a double click on my design, I am back in the Subdivision Surface Edition environment, and I can make the modifications on the zones I identified before. It should be better now, so let's check it again with the realistic view. It's better. So for me it's okay. Now I want to realize my last operation on this subdivision surface. I want to remove the faces of the bottom. So with the same function I used before for the upper hole, remove surface. And my surface is finished, like this tutorial. We learned a lot of functions of the X-Shape Design app. The next tutorial will focus on the soils design, still in this app but with the use of new functions, so don't miss it guys. See you in the next video. Bye! You are interested in the 3D experience? TPS supports you with webinars, specialized trainings, customized coaching, but also services and integration offerings of the platform. Follow us on the social media or on our website tps-fr.com, and don't hesitate to visit our channel.